Tennis Hall of Famer. He needs no introduction. John McEnroe, the New Yorker, the legend, joining us here. Inside Out Tennis, Jim Courier does a great job.
He's been working at it, and it's tough times right now, but he's got a good product, and I think we've got some credibility, and I made it this far. I think it's time for him and Pete and obviously guys like Martin to try to step up and see what happens the next couple of years, but we play hard. I think we put on a pretty good show, so hopefully people continue to support it.
What keeps you coming out here?
I love it. I get to compete a little bit, get the juices flowing, and the fact that I get out there, see how much harder the guys are hitting the ball, even on this tour, and the premium more than ever on fitness. So actually it's helped me as I've gotten older to sort of enjoy that part of it.
You beat Pete Sampras last year. You hit with Rafael Nadal before he beat Federer at Wimbledon. You can still play, John.
Well, it was great to get out there to see that type of spin. I mean, Pete's got the greatest serve volley I've ever seen. And he just makes you so edgy every time you play. But Nadal was just—it was really a lot of fun to get out there on the court before his semis. And I felt like Albert Brooks in broadcast news because I hit just before I went on the air, and I knew I was going to be sweating and I wouldn't be able to calm down. But I didn't care because it's the first time I'd ever gotten a chance to hit with them, and it was fun.
The world of tennis is great. Nadal wins the Australian Open. Serena wins the Australian Open. What do you think about the world of tennis? Can't get more exciting right now.
Well, the rivalry is great between Rafa and Roger, obviously. And he's gotten in his head, which is incredibly hard to do, obviously. And if Serena keeps motivated, that's going to be important for the women's game. They've been struggling. People have been hurt, quitting. So if her and Venus get into it, that's going to be a big boost. So right now, I think it's a real upswing, and we got to take advantage of that.
World Team Tennis, Billie Jean King, Alana Kloss, they've done a great job. They've teamed up with the USCA. You're a big part of it with the Sports Times. What do you think about World Team?
Well, they love it. I mean, it's her heart and soul. She's so gung-ho. It's amazing. Billie Jean's unbelievable, the energy she still has. And because of that, I play, just the respect I have. And it's nice to play, do something different and play part of a team. I played team sports growing up, and so I appreciate that. That's why, one reason why I always loved Davis Cup, and to be able to go out there and sort of pull for some other people, which you can't normally do on the tour, is fun.
My final question, do you think Roger Federer can break the record of 14 Grand Slam titles?
I think he's going to break the record, but I think it's not going to be as easy as everyone anticipated. They probably thought it'd be over already. This lefty got in the way, but he's such a great player, and he wants it so bad. But he's feeling the pressure of getting this over with, and it's going to happen, but Pete Sampras is sleeping a little easier at night.
State is one of Providence's only truly upscale ultra lounges, built to be a VIP haven designed to capture a sense of luxury and refined style. Tucked away in downtown Providence, this ultra lounge is rich with fine champagnes, specialty cocktails, luxury liquor, and a perfect selection of light food, making this hideaway sensual and sophisticated. Experience the sounds of weekly live jazz or world-renowned DJs. State offers the ideal setting for your special events. Come feel the rhythm of life at State Ultra Lounge, located at 1 Through Valley in Providence. Visit stateultralounge.com or call 453-3333.